I want to ask you my last question, as I said, question. One is, who are the mentors that you learned from, gained from personally? Who are the people you look up to and why? And second, I asked you this right up front, but what is your advice to young lawyers in terms of succeeding, in terms of learning interdisciplinary skills? Because legal is a way to look at a business issue and solve it or provide a solution to fortify an issue. So these two people who have kind of helped you in your life, you've been mentored by, or you learned from, and tell us why you look up to them.
So, you know, my parents, like most people, I would say definitely my dad, who was a lawyer, and that's why even when I was a 5 or 6 year old, I was a very boring kid who immediately said, I want to be a lawyer. So it was a purely emotional decision. My mom, who's always taught me there are no shortcuts in life. You have to walk the straight line always and do the hard work. So I learned a great deal from her. And unfortunately, I lost my dad when I was very young, 15 years old. But she made sure that all of us got the best education possible. So definitely her. And finally, my wife, who is also a lawyer, a lot of lawyers in the family. She practiced for 13 years. Again, you know, very, very high sense of integrity and crazily conscientious. So definitely those are the three. For the youngsters, you know, my advice would be, just to quickly repeat what I said, it's a lot of hours, it's a lot of hard work, there are no shortcuts, but that's pretty much in most jobs in life. When you are a fresher, you have to put in the hours. So do what you enjoy. Sometimes youngsters feel that securities law is very sexy, M&A is the, you know, flavor of the month. I don't think go with that. Go with your heart. Whichever area of law suits you, you go with that if you're going to spend so many hours. And the second thing is, unless you're going to be a solo, be a team player. Enjoy your work environment, avoid the politics, and you should have at least amongst your good best friends, some of them at work, so that your life is enjoyable. So that's would be my advice to them. You know, go with what you like. Put in the hours, don't look for shortcuts in life, and you know, be good to all your colleagues.
How do you spend your time outside of work? Would you please allow us a peek into your life?
Yeah, I you know, I love traveling, which in some ways it's both work-wise and pleasure. But I certainly, you know, I'm big on traveling. I love reading. So that again, you know, partly that's why I like traveling, because it gives you more time to read away from both legal and other subjects. And I love sports. I, you know, from family, learned the passion for tennis. Been playing since I was a kid. So I think, you know, nothing really. Yeah, all the regular stuff. I mean, everything else I see again will be music. I mean, that's what comes to mind.
Thank you so much, Mr.
Any books that you read recently that you want to recommend to our readers and viewers?
You know, it will be some pretty bizarre stuff. I mean, I read The Spirit of Indian Painting by Professor Goswami. I've read some of the more recent, you know, books on, I'm just starting Urjit Patel's book. Of course, I read Raghu's book, but that was a little bit before. And then, I as I said, I'm quite, you know, a spiritual guy. So I also read a lot of books in that field. And my favorite is Eknath Eswaran.
Beautiful. We'd let you go, but I can't ask you, can't let you go before. What's that one thing that you see in, say, in Parsi, you know, one saying, one aphorism, one maxim to all your colleagues, or in English or in Hindi? You know, for example, I keep saying life is about trade-offs. So So either you can do this or you can do that. You can't do both. I mean, either you can. So what is it that you, you know, favorite thing that you say on a daily basis?
No, it's actually very easy. That for us, what I love about our religion is it's so simple. There are only three tenets: good thoughts, good words, good deeds. So if you cover those, of course, it will be in almost every religion. If you, you know, whether it's Hinduism, Buddhism, you will have these tenets. But for us, it's just that. What is being a good Zoroastrian is good thoughts, good words, good deeds. Be kind to all other living beings. And the fun part about Parsis is there are no don'ts. Kitna peena hai piyo, kitna khana hai khao. You know, anyway, they are very into food and drink. So enjoy life to the maximum, but be a good human being.
Fantastic. I think, Mr. Wakil, you exemplify achieving and, you know, being who you are. So at BW Legal World and Business World, we're grateful to you for your time and your thoughts. And we look forward to having another conversation with you soon enough. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thanks a lot.